Dear students, today we deal with our paper first. Animal systematics and diversity first. This paper deals with the syllabus animal classification, binomial nomenclature and invertebrate phylum series from phylum protozoa to phylum Aeschylmanthes. Now here from phylum protozoa we have to study animal type name as paramecium. So this is protozoan animal observed in pond water, where in that pond water there is abundance of bacteria, abundance of decaying vegetable matter and with other food material, that is smaller protozoa, decaying animal bodies, hay infusions, etc. Now in this pond water we have to observe this fast swimming creature. Now this animal is not hunted, the prey. It is actively swimmer and microscopic animal and thus belongs to phylum protozoa. In them locomotory organelles are cilia. Now in first lecture via Google Meet we people study all the details about paramecium, that is external features of paramecium, its class, order, genus and species, pod atom. External features, that is animal body looks like a sole of a sleeper, so it is known as sleeper animal food. Now the first study after classification external features, we have to study the process of nutrition in paramecium, or it is known as process of cyclosis. Now observe this process, cyclosis. Here in this topic we deal with cyclosis, digestion and assimilation, process of egestion, excretion, reproduction and binary fission. Now at first we concentrate towards the process of cyclosis. Now the food vacuole is fully formed when it is laden with food material taken by ingestion of food via the oral groove of paramecium along with the water current, etc. The food vacuole is formed at the tip of cytopharynx, and when it is with maximum food material it is pinched off or it is separated from the cytopharynx. Now the food vacuole moves in a definite path with the streaming movement of the endoplasm, means the endoplasm circulates within the body. The movement of food vacuoles thus called as cyclosis, because during movement of food vacuole or during its tour within the food vacuole towards downward direction, anteriorward direction, right side, left side, So during this tour, the food within the food vacuoles get digested. Now several vacuoles are seen circulating in the endoplasm of paramecium. So after the formation of these food vacuole, it passes to the posterior end of the body. So food within food vacuole get digested because along the rotary streaming movement of endoplasm, it passes forward up to the anterior end of the body, then dorsal side, then again ventral towards ventral surface, and then towards the anus, that is cytoplasm, for elimination purpose or for casting of undigested food particles. Now the food vacuole remains in the body for the period of at least 3 hours. Now this is the animal body. Here we observe these pink colored structures known as food vacuoles, yellow colored, blue colored structure located at anterior end and posterior end. It is known as osmoregulatory device. It is star shaped, known as the contractile vacuoles. Now observe here the dark yellowish structure, kidney shaped structure known as macronucleus or meganucleus, and associated with this there is a micronucleus. Now observe this yellow colored structure towards right side known as oral groove, buccal cavity and cytopharynx, and at the end of cytopharynx we observe the food formation of food vacuoles. The small black colored dots are endoplasm, peripheral black colored dots are ectoplasm. Body shape, it is limited by the pellicular membrane. From this membrane, cilia originates. Here this black dots means endoplasm, shows rotary streaming motion. As per this, the food vacuoles get circulated and food within the food vacuoles get digestion. Food vacuoles within the food vacuole get digested. Now during the course of circulation, digestive enzymes, that is proteases, carbohydrates and lipases, are secreted by the lysosomes, the food vacuoles. The medium of the food vacuole, at first it is acidic, means pH range is about 2 to 4, and then it becomes alkaline. Here pH range changes. Now the acidic phase usually kills the prey. So most digestive activity takes place within the food vacuole and its contained, and thus the proteolytic enzyme, it acts on the food within the food vacuole and ranges the pH of food content in between 5.7 to 5.8. Now thus the proteinous part within the food material are hydrolyzed into amino acids, carbohydrate part hydrolyzes into glucose by the enzymes. Then the fat is digested by the action of lipases. So this digestive ferment acted on foodstuff of food vacuole and food get digested. Now the digested food material is equally distributed to all parts of the body during process of cyclosis. So the digested food is absorbed by the surrounding cytoplasm and it is built up into the protoplasm or physiological status maintenance of paramecium. The glycogen and fat droplets are scattered throughout the endoplasm and are stored. Now the food vacuole gradually becomes smaller due to digestion and absorption process of food. Now the undigestible residue food material is thrown out, means undigested residue passes towards the cytotrophic region, towards the temporary aperture known as cytotroph or cytophage or animal anus. And this ingestion of undigested residue via the cytotroph is known to be process of egestion. So when we concentrate towards the further step, that is excretory system in paramecium, we observe in paramecium special excretory organelles are absent. Therefore, the best products of cellular metabolism, it is removed from the protoplasm, from the endoplasm by simple diffusion through general body surface into surrounding water. Now, because of this, the concentration is always higher as compared with the waste products or nitrogenous substances. So the residual diffusion takes place. Now the contractile vacuoles also eliminate waste products and they function as osmoregulatory device, osmoregulatory organs. When water from the living media of paramecium enters the cytoplasm, then within the body of paramecium, the loaded ammonia, nitrogenous waste, it is excreted via contractile vacuole. Thus, contractile vacuole act as the osmoregulatory device organs in paramecium. Now, the crystals and crystalline granules are present in the cytoplasm, which are the catabolic products of day-to-day metabolism by taking foodstuff and their degradation. So, the first it is dissolved and eliminated by the contractile vacuole via its terminal canal. Now, when we consider the reproduction behavior, now in via Google Meet, we study this binary fission and conjugation in detail. In this slide, for review purpose, put forth certain views prior to reproduction in paramecium. That is, the asexual mode of reproduction, it is known to be binary fission, and sexual mode of reproduction, it is known to be conjugation in paramecium. So, asexual reproduction by binary fission and sexual reproduction by conjugation, and endomixis, hemixis, cytogamy, autogamy, syngamy, etc. So, most species of paramecium podatom reproduces asexually by means of transverse binary fission. So it is homoketogenic fission, means it takes place under favorable conditions where there is ample of water, there is good conditions, ample of food material in the pond water, etc. So the optimum temperature conditions are there, plenty of food material is there, this is the favorable conditions. So before binary fission, fully grown paramecia stop feeding, locomotion and other functions. Now the body becomes elongated like a spindle shape, oral groove and buccal structures disappear in binary fission. Then transverse constriction develops prior to animal body. Two cytopharynx budded off along the both sides of paramecia internally, and the micronucleus divides by the process of mitosis, enlarges and shows at least 150 chromosomes depending on the species or the race of paramecium. Now, after mitotic division of the chromosomes, the two sets move to the opposite ends of the micronucleus, which has become much more elongated. Now finally divides into two daughter micronuclei at each end of the mother body. So the middle piece of old micronucleus breaks, disappears. So the division of meganucleus or macronucleus takes place, but it is the mitotic process. Now the meganucleus simply elongates, narrows down and divides transversely to produce new meganucleus at each end, at both ends of paramecium body. Now here the actual division occurs, cytopharynx is budded off and it also develops at anterior end and posterior end. Thus two cytopharynx is visible at the ends of paramecium body. New contractile vacuole is formed at anterior end as well as at posterior end. Meanwhile, there develops a constriction furrow at the mediator of animal body. It deepens down, it closes closer down, and consequently at that region the cytoplasm is divided. So the connection completely divides the parent into two daughter paramecia at equal size. So the anterior part which is developed, it is known as putter, and the posterior part, it is known as opacity. Here is one opacity. Now the posterior part is opacity. Now we observe this binary fusion. Observe here elongation of micronucleus, elongation of meganucleus, two contractile vacuoles budded off at anterior side, one is at posterior side. Similarly, a constriction furrow is marked at the mediator of body. Newly formed contractile vacuoles are there, and two daughter paramecia is there. Anterior one is proter, posterior one is ST. Now the entire process of binary fusion, it is completed within 30 to 120 minutes, depending upon water and quality and quantity of food. However, at least 300 such asexual generations takes place, and so as to survive these generations on Earth, some of these formed paramecia, they attain old healthy age. For survival purpose, they undergo further process known as sexual reproduction for the purpose of maintaining its vigor, etc. Now, thank you very much for attending this lecture. Very interesting topic, that is the process of cyclosis in paramecia. Thank you very much. Now, this e-content online bridge is for you people. It is for convenience of you people. It is for increasing your knowledge, betterment, your comfort. Now, thanks once again. Thank you.